industry is able to take on, they are able to produce many of the parts, then many of the subsystems, and many of them have entered into a very critical systems also today. We have industry which is producing composite rocket motors, there is industry which is producing metallic rocket motors, engines industry is able to produce. Then coming to the electronic side, industry is able to produce very critical seekers today. Then they are able to produce even IR seekers, RF seekers. The power supply is completely dependent on the industry today. In the navigation systems, industry is able to produce. And even sensors, of course, today it's public sector which is producing, is able to do. It's only that the integration of the missiles as a whole, industry is not able to take. Again, there are certain policies need to be changed, particularly handling the explosives. That's the bottleneck, wherein the clearances from the government should be obtained for the explosives to be manufactured or explosives to be handled rather. So this is one of the areas, so probably that also will be changing. We had a couple of meetings with the RM Raksha Mantri, and in this direction there are a lot of changes, a lot of policies are going to change, more industry friendly policies are going to come, and many of the things like we had a conference here called FINS, wherein Raksha Mantri himself attended. In fact, he was suggesting there itself, probably you would have heard him saying that gradually we'll bring in a policy wherein we'll stop imports, take the area by area and say that we will not be allowing the imports to come in and forcing the country to make those systems. Probably I'm sure missiles is one of the areas which is the first area where such a policy will be coming phase by phase in the next 3 to 4 years. So if I look at it, these are all the various aspects of the talk, what I want to say here and what is going to be there. May not be next 30 years, probably next about 15 years we can say that. And if you look at it, this is how the weapon development phases in the defense, particularly if you look at it, what's the typical weapon life cycle cost, but about 5% R&D and then procurement, many of the materials, many of the components, what you procure in, and 29% for the production, operation and maintenance and various phases. So these are the concept, technology development, system development, production and development, and sustained disposal and